Welcome. This is a presentation about arterial blood gas sampling education and using the Venatech IV trainer. The purpose of this presentation is to show you how I use the Venatech IV trainer to educate my students on how to draw arterial blood gases in the laboratory setting. So, something that I wanted to find for my students was equipment that they could manipulate better to be more human-like. And what I have found in the Venatech IV trainer is that there's the ability to do that. I also wanted to find something that was easier to clean and replace parts. So maybe this is something that if you teach arterial blood gas draws, you could incorporate. Okay, so the Venatech IV trainer comes from NASCO Lifeform, and this is a picture of the kit that you'll get. So you can see here, this is the part of the IV trainer that goes on your wrist or a mannequin's wrist, and you can see that it has the arteries, and in the middle is a vein because it's also a venous trainer too. It comes with a skin that covers your tubing, and the skins come in different colors. It comes with an instructional manual, 5-year limited warranty, disposable pad, the syringe, and then it comes with a blue and red dye and an extra end cap for your tubing. Okay, so this is a picture of a simulator that we have in our respiratory lab, and he is also affectionately known as Mitch MacGyver. But you can see that I have set up the Venatech IV trainer on his right and left arm, so it can be used on either side, which is great when you're training students because this allows them to practice drawing from both sides. I'm ambidextrous when it comes to blood gas drawing. I can draw from either side and I can switch hands, but some people can't do that. So I like to set this up so students can practice coming up with the best way to draw from a patient and just fumble around in lab. So when they go out and they're actually doing this on real patients, they don't look like human pretzels trying to figure out how to draw a blood gas. And we also like this because since you can use it on either side, you can replicate a weaker pulse on one arm, so it would make them go over and check the other arm. Maybe you can just simulate that there's no pulse on that wrist. So there's a lot of scenarios that you can use by using the Venatech IV trainer for your students. Here are a couple of pictures on an actual human. This is my arm, and that simulates how you could use it, like when a patient's lying in a bed. And then this is one of my students sitting at a table. Okay, this is a student of mine sitting at a table, and this is just a video to show how the pumping mechanism works. You can see that there's the fake blood in the syringe, and the student's going to simulate the pulse. And it doesn't take very much effort to simulate that pulse. This is a video showing two of my students in lab practicing blood gas sticks. The one student who is the patient, she'll be pumping to simulate that pulse, and the other student will be doing the actual stick. So you can see the blood being pumped and the student sticking. Okay, so some of the pros for this are it is easier to assemble and clean. It's smaller than the big long arms, So it doesn't take as much tubing. And if you're using that fake blood, there's not a big of a mess in the system. And also, it's easier to replace the parts because you can get the skin off easier. If you've ever used one of the mannequin arms, it's really hard to get the skin off of the arm. And then once you replace the tubing, it's even harder to get the skin back on the arm. The one thing I really do like is the manipulation ability to stick it on a real person and to be able to learn how to manipulate a real patient's arms. It also is very cost effective. The average cost is about $70 for the kit versus $500 and up for the actual full arm. And the replacement parts, depending on what you get, are between $10 and $35. Another cost effective thing about the Venatech IV arm is the fact that it does do venous draws. So if your budget is pretty tight and you have like a nursing program or phlebotomy program, or even in a hospital, if you want to use this between departments, you could share the cost among the departments. The cons of this system are is when you are pumping the syringe and increasing that pressure, if you do it too hard, that red end cap will fly off, causing all of the fluid in your system to spray your so-called patient. And students don't typically like that. So what I came up with is just put an adhesive glue right inside of this part of the tubing, and then just took a zip tie to kind of hold it on there better. The glue dries up, and that has seemed to be pretty effective. And the other con, of course, is that it's not a real person. Nothing's as good as the real thing. In our program, we don't allow students to draw on each other for liability issues, if somebody damages a vessel. So that is the only other con. All in all, I've had great success with using this. The students really enjoy it. It gives you a lot more ways to teach how to draw blood gases, different scenarios. I just have really had great success with this. My resources, you can find more about this on enasco.com, and of course, all three students in my presentation agreed that they would let me use their picture for this presentation. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any more questions or want some more information about it, feel free to contact me. Thank you.